another thrilling episode of Lumberjack Barbecue. Today, what we're going to do is we're going to make barbecue rotisserie chicken thighs. These are boneless, skinless chicken thighs. And first thing we're going to do is season them up a little bit with this Kinder's Tequila Lime Rub. I forget where I got this, probably, you know, at any grocery store. I guess that's Mr. Kinder there. Over 70 years, and this is good for pork, chicken, and fish. So we're going to try it on this chicken. And we'll just gently disperse it because I'm getting close to the end, so I want to make sure everything, all sides, get a little bit of this. I did test cook this last weekend, and it turned out good. Everybody seemed to like it. And that rotisserie just does something to it because it's, as the barbecue pit boy would say, it's an anti-gravity machine. And that's what it does. It just, the juices stay right on it. I'm going to use this bowl here to keep it. We're going to be going over the in-laws today. It's going to be up to almost 90 degrees here in Pennsylvania. So we're looking forward to spending some time up there, as always, and drinking some beers and playing some, I haven't played in so long. Oh, cornhole. I'm going to play some cornhole. And just open these up. Get a little seasoning in there, throw them in there. What's going to happen is we're going to have them all completely open. We're going to throw them on the spit rod and just mash them all together. And I'm telling you, this works really, really good. Got a little barbecue sauce later on that I mixed with some different things out of the fridge, like soy sauce, apple cider vinegar. I think I put some sauce in there, or Worcester sauce, Worcestershire. And a little bit of water, and that's what we're doing. So we'll get you, look at that little guy, he's gonna get a sandwich right in the middle somewhere. We'll bring it back when we're getting ready to shish kebab these. I can't put these on, not shish kebab, it is like that. I can't put them on the spit yet because the spit doesn't fit in the refrigerator, so I gotta wait till I get up to our little site, and then I'll be able to take care of that. So we'll see you then. The in-laws place, hanging out, doing our thing. We're gonna get this rotisserie going. What do we have here? 400 degrees. We'll show you the setup inside when we get to it. There's that chicken. We're gonna dump it out. And I got this set up exactly where it should be. We're just gonna start loading the chicken on and putting it on the tongs, or whatever you call these things, and just slowly load it. Now, of course, we're going to break away from this because you don't want to watch all of this. There's a lot of chicken to be loading up on here, but you just keep on loading it like that. Real easy to do, as the barbecue pit boys would say. Now, this little one I'm sandwiching in between, and that's what they keep on alternating. And notice that this had the tines here. There's short ones, longer ones, and then they're also wider too, as you can see. So if you have a really short piece of meat, well, then you would go with the shorter tines. But if you have a longer piece of meat, well, then you go with the longer ones. So that's what we're doing. We'll show you when we throw it on the grill here. We're on the rotisserie. All right, we got it all loaded up. Short tines right here on this one. Short tines over here. That way when we go down here like this, hopefully we don't interfere too much. And there we go, we got it locked in. Next thing we're gonna do is lay that down there. I got a blocky hand here. Pull this off. I've already got the motor loaded up over here, ready to go. We got our bearing right here. That way it doesn't wear this out too much. And we are going to load this up like this and just see how it bounces. Does it want to go to one side or the other? And it seems like it's... It really feels like it's heavy down here. So what I'm going to have to do is loosen this up. And put this weight up here like this. With my blucky hand. And now let's see, now it's heavy there. So we can loosen it up and bring it down a little bit more. Instead of being up so high. And that'll help to keep the motor from having too much strain. So we lock it in the square hole over there, lock our bearing in, there it goes. Hit our switch, ba-boom. I got coals on both sides, water pans in the center, just to keep some moisture. You can see it's getting close to boiling in there, which is good. There's some steam and humidity up in there. After a while, I have some, what do you want to call it? Something to spritz it with. Not spritz it, but I'm going to, it's that Worcester I was talking about, Worcester sauce, and the, what's this here sauce, and the soy sauce, and all the sauces, and whatever, with some water. And that will baste it. There we go. Baste. Baste. That's what we're going to do with it. All right. So I'll check what time it is, and we'll see how long this takes. Stick around. So it's 45 minutes in. There we are, about 325. And let's take a look. Oh, baby, that's looking good.
Dynamite.
So we're gonna stop it and just do a little temp check. I don't think they're done, but you never know. Let's see right in here. Yeah, I didn't think so. 96, something like that. All right. But I'd like to do a little bit of basting. So I got this mixture right here. We're gonna turn this back on and just drizzle a little bit over. While you were gone, I put in some not mesquite, what's that wood called? Well, I put some smoking wood in there. I'll probably remember it after a while. And it's been very light smoke, to be honest with you. This thing is doing good. And we're just going to try to just baste it a little bit, put a little juice on there. It's going to drip here and there or whatever. Later on, we got some barbecue sauce to go on here. And that's what's going on. It's looking good. There's no drain on the motor. When it comes around, if the camera girl will get a look at that, it doesn't like lag here and there or drop real quick. It's moving the way it's supposed to move. So we got a good cook going in here. My test cook went not as good as this, I can tell you that much. So I'm really happy. Going good. We'll come back in about maybe half an hour, 45 minutes. Oh, all right. What are we at here? Just about 350. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I don't think they're there yet, but boy, I'll tell you what, they're looking good. This thermometer here, what is it, a Saferel or something like that? You open it and it goes on, you close it, turns off. Here, stop the rotisserie. Take a little reading. Hey, 48. I mean 148, 52. We're gonna do a little more basting. So we'll turn it on, open up our container, and get the basting. We're soon ready for barbecue sauce. I almost thought we were because of how they're looking. And then guess what? My mother-in-law says she's gonna make some chicken sandwich with this, with mayo and maybe some pickles. We're gonna be like, what the heck's that place name again?
Chick-fil-A.
So we're going to see what's going on here. But we're going to just baste it again a little bit more. Keep it nice and tender. And of course, thighs are tender to begin with. You can go up to 175 on these babies. And we're within our time limit here. I'll tell you what. What are we at now? About an hour and 20 minutes. Hour and a half. My father-in-law says too long. And there we go. I'm thinking another 15, 20 minutes, we're going to be ready to sauce them. And there we are.
And the secret ingredient.
What's the secret ingredient?
Honeysuckle.
No, that is not going in this. That's a wrap, folks. Well, don't you know, the plan has worked out. this is going on here. What are we at? Well, that's 275, I guess. There you go. Let's check it out. I have to admit, I already checked it out. It's ready to go. Oh, gotta turn it off. Hey, hey, what's going on? Yeah, we're there. I mean, 160. 62. We're gonna barbecue sauce this baby. And we're there. Hey, what the hell's going on? All right, we gotta take the cap off. I experienced this before because there's a lot of seasonings in here. So we're just gonna slather this on. That's right, get it going. We're gonna get another 15 minutes, pulling them off, and then my mother-in-law is gonna make some awesome sandwiches. Oh yeah, that looks delicious. That's about 8 thighs in there, packed together.
Are you all done now, Jim?
Oh, it'll be really good. I'm telling you what, last weekend I made these and they were good, but I think these are going to be even better. The next time you see us, you're going to see me digging into some of this, or somebody else here.
Stick around.
They're ready. It's been 15 minutes. What are we at here? Well, like 260 or something like that. Oh, yeah. That's right. That's what we're talking about right there. We'll turn this off. I'm going to pull this out of the motor here. We're going to put it on the tray. Undo this. Oh, yeah. Come on, stay over here. I got my flipper here just in case something like that happens. Hopefully I can get it to move away. I mean, this stuff falling apart here. Look at that. Come on, get off there. Then we're gonna influence the rest of them to move over on the tray so my mother-in-law can make these awesome sandwiches. That's what I'm talking about. A little smoke, some heat, some barbecue, and you know what? I'm ungloving. I'm gonna take this one and take a taste. Oh. Mm. That's just right. So, if you're looking for some barbecue or some cooking, whether it be on a griddle or rotisserie on the grill, stop by Lumberjack PA, otherwise known as Lumberjack Barbecue, and check out our videos. Subscribe, share, like, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.